السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا
بتقوى الله عز وجل، كما قال تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل، آمين يا رب العالمين. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we were discussing in the last khutbah about a gathering which will be you and me, all of us are going to be part of it. Sooner or later, we are going to be in that land of Yawm Hashr, Yawm al-Hashr, on the day of gathering. On the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call all of us, those who died, or those who were here from the very first day till the last day, everyone will come, will be going towards that land of Hashr. Today, inshallah, we are going to talk about, further inshallah, about the day of Qiyamah. One of the name of the judgment day is Yawmul Qiyamah. Now Qiyam in Arabic means standing. The day of standing, that we all will be standing, as we discussed in detail in last khutbah. Urat, we will be naked, barefoot, circumcised. Everyone will be worried about himself or herself. So imagine for a moment, brothers and sisters, that we are there. Imagine for a moment, at the time when we are sitting here, me delivering the khutbah, you are listening, we have a plans. After 30, 40 minutes, I'm going to go out and I have my business, I have my job, I have my family to take care of. I have planning for the day. We have planning for our day, for tomorrow, for next 10 years. We have things going on in our mind. But imagine for a moment when you and me are standing in that land, Yawmul Hashr, Yawmul Qiyamah, and we all are aware of what's going on now. At this point, when I'm talking to you about the books of Allah, about the verses of Allah, maybe Shaytan can come and play his role. Some of us will be here for the 50% of the khutbah, listen to it, half of the khutbah we are somewhere else. But on the day of Qiyamah, brothers and sisters, we all will be standing and everything will be open, wide, clear. We can see angels, we can see the jinn, we can see our book and all that. And you know, brothers and sisters, the life about which we are thinking, we will live here for 67, 60, 80 years. But the day we are talking about, just one day is 50,000 years. مِقْدَارُهُ خَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةً. Ask yourself, is there any comparison between this world and the Akhirah? يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. So I request you to just feel that we are there. We're just standing the way we are sitting here. And we are on Yawmul Qiyamah, the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to judge us. We discussed the categories of the people in the last khutbah, and I discussed only one, and those were the believers. We said those people who were on Tawheed, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Imagine if there is a darkness. We will be standing and there will be darkness. Now all of us are there. Right? But there will be certain category of people who will be shaded under the shade of Allah on the day of Qiyamah, when sun will be just few miles away. And out of those million, trillion, zillions of people, you know, few of them will be shaded. The source, as we discussed, seven people Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in his hadith, and the sadaqah, a sadaqatu, you know, it will be a will for a person, it will be a shade for a person on the day of Qiyamah, a person who used to help others, person who freed the slave, the person who had the istiqamah, all those people, they will have no fear. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. They will not have any fear. And those 50,000 years will be just few moments for them. Few moments for them. Allah Azza wa Jalla will make it easy for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among them. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. But brother and sister, there will be certain category of people. The second category of the people who said the kalima la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, they were on tawheed, but they had committed few sins. So in today's khutbah, we will discuss those sins. If we will not repent, on the day when we will be standing, Yawmul Qiyamah, we will be in trouble. We will be in serious trouble if we don't repent. The first sin is the person who is al-ghadir, the betrayer, the person who betrays others. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, إِذَا جَمَعَ اللَّهُ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to gather all of us, the first person and the last person on the day of Qiyamah, يُرْفَعُ لِكُلِّ غَادِرٍ لِوَا فَيُقَالُ هَذِهِ غَدْرَةُ فُلَانَ هَذِهِ وَهَذِهِ غَدْرَةُ فُلَانَ. The person who used to betray others in this world, he will have a flag. And that flag will be showing Hadi, Hadihi, Mudratu Fulan. This is a betrayer of so and so. This is a betrayer of so and so. We can betray each other maybe in this world, knowing that the other person doesn't know. يَعْلَمُ سِرَّكُمْ وَجَهْرَكُمْ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْسِبُونَ. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. He knows what is in our heart. He knows our intention. So on the day of Qiyamah, there will be a flag saying this person is betrayer of such and such. So this will be one of the sin. In the land, Yawm al-Qiyamah, on the day of standing, this will be one of the category of the people. Another sin, a person, if he doesn't repent, he will be in serious trouble on the day when he will be standing on the in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the al-ghalul, the person who was stealing. Akilu maybe zakatul mal. He was in charge of zakat and he was eating that mal. Or he was, you know, stealing the war booty, as Allah says, وَمَنْ يَغْلُلْ يَأْتِ بِمَا غَلَّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Whoever steals, whoever does the ghulul, he will be, that ghul will be brought on the day of Qiyamah. The person who doesn't pay zakah, the compulsory, you know, the money he has to, you know, give his, you know, from his wealth or from his gold or silver that he or she has, there will be a severe punishment for those kind of people, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in the hadith. The wealth will be transformed into a huge snake with two black spots above his eye, and he will bite that person. And this is what we are talking about. We will be standing. All of us will be standing, and this is what happening with that kind of person who was not paying zakah. This is what going on with that person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ بِمَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ هو خيرا لهم بل هو شر لهم سيطوقون ما بخلوا به يوم القيامة. The day of standing, that wealthy things he is stingy, he doesn't want to spend. That wealth will be, you know, his neck will be surrounded with that wealth. سيطوقون ما بخلوا به يوم القيامة. And about those brothers and sisters who has that gold or silver and they're not paying zakah, according to the fiqh of Abu Hanifa, that the ladies who are even using their gold or silver for their daily use, they have to pay zakah. Zakah from that, Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبُ وَالْفِضَّةُ وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَهَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ يَوْمَ يُحْمَى عَلَيْهَا فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ فَتُكْوَى بِهَا جِبَاهُهُمْ وَجُنُوبُهُمْ وَظُهُورُهُمْ هَذَا مَا كَنَزْتُمْ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ هَذَا مَا كَنَزْتُمْ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ فَذُوقُوا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْنِزُونَ. There will be a severe punishment for those who are not paying from the zakah, the due zakah, from the gold or silver or from the mal. A person who is arrogant, who will be standing Yawm al-Qiyamah, there will be a people who committed this kind of sin. They were mutakabbir. And Allah will call, أَيْنَ الْمُتَكَبِّرُونَ بِجَلَالِي. Where are those arrogant people? I was Malik al-Mulk. Who, where are those who used to call them as the king of the kings? أَيْنَ الْمُتَكَبِّرُونَ بِجَلَالِي. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ مَنْ كَانَ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِنَ الْكِبْرِ. Allahu Akbar. A person will not enter in Jannah if he has arrogance in his heart? No. He said, if he has arrogance equal to مِثْقَالِ ذَرَّةٍ, equal to an atom, weight. You cannot even see that atom. He will not enter in Jannah. In the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يُحْشَرُ الْمُتَكَبِّرُونَ أَمْثَالَ الذَّرِّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي صُوَرِ الرِّجَالِ. Again, I'm reminding you and myself, brothers and sisters, we are talking about يَوْمُ الْحَشَرِ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. We all will be standing. And these are the categories of people who will be suffering all of this. Now, مُتَكَبِّر, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he will be transformed into a small ant. Now you see, there are people from day one to last, and there will be people who are just like small ant. People will be stepping over them. Allahu Akbar. They were arrogant in this world. Look at what happened with them on the day of Qiyamah. Another category of the people who live luxurious life in this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed them with mal, and they were enjoying the life. And now, I'm sure we don't have that misconception that if Allah blessed us, as Rasulullah says in the hadith, if Allah blesses you with mal, you it should be shown in your clothing, in your, you know, in your way of, you know, living. It should be. But it should not lead us to forget Allah Azza wa Jal. It should not lead us that, you know, our wealth is you know, overtaking us. We are, it is not bringing us closer to Allah. As I mentioned, we are not even paying the zakat out of the man that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with. But of course, those people who were suffering, who were poor in this world, ghuraba, who were ghareeb, they were poor. Of course, they will have favor on the day of Qiyamah. As one of the hadith says, they will enter so many years before the rich people. So many years before the rich people. Another category of the sin, Yawm al-Qiyamah will see the categories of the people. One who seized the land unjustly, ghasib al-ard. You know, there was land and he, you know, take it unjustly. Dhul wajhayn, the person who has two faces. In front of you he is something else, on your back he is something else. Dhul wajhayn, he will be punished if he doesn't repent on the day of Qiyamah, on the day when we will be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, a person having two faces, a person who has two faces, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let his tongue, Allah will make his tongue of, you know, out of fire. His tongue will be of fire on the day of Qiyamah. Another category of the person who was in charge, but he does not take care, he doesn't know the needs of the people. He was the ruler, but he doesn't know what's going on. Umar radiallahu anhu, we know about him, what he used to do. He used to go out and he used to go to different houses. Of course, he used to see what's going on. And that's what we see in the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They used to know what's happening. And at night when everyone used to sleep, they used to go out and see how the people are. The person who was in charge, who was the ruler, and he doesn't know the needs of the people, he will be on the day of Qiyamah, on the day of standing, will be in serious trouble. A person who begs, meanwhile, he has the means. Sometimes people, they take it as a profession. They are professional beggars. They just go and ask people. Although they don't, you know, they have sufficient means. Another category of the people will be a person who spit towards the Qibla with the intention that, you know, he insulting the Kaaba, because Kaaba, Qibla, is a secret. As Rasulullah told us, one of the etiquette when we enter in the bathroom, should not face, or our back should not be towards Qibla. And we mentioned this hadith before as well. Once Rasulullah saw a spit on the towards the Qibla and he himself removed it. The person who intentionally had to show the insult towards the Qibla, his spit, on the day of Qiyamah, Rasulullah said he will raise and will have spit on his face. He will have spit on his face. Imagine, on the day of, you know, Qiyamah, we all are standing and the person has spit on his face because of this act. Lying regarding your dream. Sometimes we see such category of people, they just come and they say, this is what I saw in the dream, and it doesn't happen in reality. That will be another category of the people. The person who hears the conversation of two, that conversation that he is not supposed to, or he is not, he should not listen to, but he listens, he tries to, you know, just... That will be another category of the people on the day of Qiyamah, on the day when all of us will be standing. These will be the category of the people, they will be in the punishment. Involved in riba, interest. الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ الرِّبَى لَا يَقُومُونَ إِلَّا كَمَا يَقُومُ الَّذِي يَتَخَبَّطُهُ الشَّيْطَانُ مِنَ النَّسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, those who consume interest, يَأْكُلُونَ الرِّبَى لَا يَقُومُونَ, they will not, you know, stand on the day of Qiyamah, إِلَّا كَمَا يَقُومُ الَّذِي يَتَخَبَّطُهُ الشَّيْطَانُ مِنَ النَّسِ, except one who stands, that who is being beaten by shaitan into sanity. The one who turns away from Allah's command, He will be in trouble that we all will be standing on the day of Qiyamah, on the day of standing. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. He will be raised, he will be standing, and he will be عَمِي. He will be blind. The one who turns his back from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from Allah's command, and the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. آكِلُوا مَالَ الْيَتِيمِ. The person who eats the mal of yatim, who takes the mal of yatim, orphan, and misleading, as Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ أَمْوَالَ الْيَتَامَى ظُلْمًا إِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُونَ فِي بُطُونِهِمْ نَارًا. Those who take the mal, the wealth of the orphans unjustly, their batan, their stomach will be full of fire on the day of Qiyamah. The person who is killed, and on the day of Qiyamah, when all of us will be standing, he will be dragging his killer, the person who murdered him, the person who killed him, he will be dragging him on the day of Qiyamah. And remember, brothers and sisters, we are talking about all this, and we'll be standing there where كَانَ مِقْدَارُهُ خَمْسِنَّ أَلْفَ سَنَةً. One day equals to 50,000 years. Imagine for a moment. Some people, their faces will be dark on the day of Qiyamah. All of us will be standing, and some of the people, their faces will be dark. And who will be those people? And Allah says, وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تَرَى الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ وُجُوهُهُمْ مُسْوَدًّا. On the day of Qiyamah, when all of you will be standing, there will be a category of people who lied against Allah. كَذَبُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ وُجُوهُهُمْ مُسْوَدًّا. Their faces will be dark. The person who backbite, slandered, he will be or she will have the nails made up of copper, and they will, you know, scratch their mouth and their, you know, faces on the day of Qiyamah. And a person who has two wives, but he was inclined towards one of them, on the day of Qiyamah, he will come in a way that he is inclined, you know, to one side, like this. And he will be coming, and he will be there on the day of Qiyamah, which has two wives, but he was not just to both of them, he was inclined more to one of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who will be standing on the day of Qiyamah, those who are called believers, those who will call to, who will be called, who will come to the lane of Hashar, Uqbalan, writing inshaAllah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا لا ينفد أفضل ما ينبغي أن يحمد وصلى الله وسلم على مصطفينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تعبد. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, in the last khutbah we are discussing the categories of the people that will be standing on the day of Qiyamah. In the land of Hashr, in the land of gathering, there will be three categories of people. One will be the believers, as we talked in the last khutbah. The other, the second category of people will be, they are tawheed. They said, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, but they committed sins and they did not repent. And those sins, based on which they will be in trouble on the day of standing, on the day of Qiyamah, we have discussed some of those sins. Another category of the people, or the same category, but another type of people will be, about which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a few hadith. He said that Allah will not look towards them. لا يكلمهم الله يوم القيامة. Allah will not speak to them. ولا ينظر إليهم. Allah will not look towards them. ولا يزكيهم. Allah will not honor them. ولهم عذاب أليم. And they will have severe punishment. If you get, you know, if you put it together, those ayah of the Quran, the verses of the Quran, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used these words, and those ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he mentioned that there will be certain categories of the people whom Allah will not look. Imagine you are in a gathering, and there is a chief guest, Right? And he doesn't, you know, care about you. Right? He shakes hands with everyone except you. What you will feel? He doesn't even look towards you. He doesn't honor you. You know, sometimes you go in a gathering and you are honored by the chief guest, special honor. How you feel? And imagine if you are ignored. And ignored by Allah. Allahu Akbar. What are those people? We put it together, inshallah. One, the person who is concealing the truth. He knows the truth in his heart. For example, those rabbis, those pastors, they know that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been mentioned in the Quran, but still they are concealing their truth. They are not sharing it to others, but they are not believing it by them. Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْتُمُونَ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَيَشْتَرُونَ بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا أولئك ما يأكلون في بطونهم إلا النار ولا يكلمهم الله يوم القيامة ولا يزكيهم ولهم عذاب أليم. Those who conceal the truth, Allah will not, you know, look towards them, and Allah will not honor them on the day of Qiyamah, and they will have severe punishment. Those who break the promises of Allah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَشْتَرُونَ بِعَهْدِ اللَّهِ وَأَيْمَانِهِمْ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا أُولَٰئِكَ لَا خَلَاقَ لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَلَا يُزَكِّيهِمْ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Another hadith in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned three categories of people. ثَلَاثَةٌ. These three people, Allah will not talk to them. Allah will not look towards them on the day of Qiyamah. Allah will not honor them, and they will have severe punishment. What are those? Al-Musbil, the one whose garment is below ankle. And some of the scholars, they have the interpretation that this is because of the arrogance, because of the takabbur, he or she keeps his or her garment below the ankle. Al-Musbil, Allah will not talk to him or her. وَالْمُنْفِقُ صِلْعَةُ بِالْحَلَفِ الْكَاذِبِ. One who takes oath on his commodity in order to sell it. Wallahi is the best. No. This is the best I have. You're selling the car, you're saying, although you know there's a fault, but you're حَلْفِ الْكَاذِبِ. You're taking the oath, but you're lying. Allah will not look towards those people. الْمَنَّان. The person who reminds the favor. He does favor to someone, and then he keeps on reminding him or her. Remember I did this to you? Remember this I did to you? Al-Mannan. لا يكلمهم الله يوم القيامة. Who is saying it? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah will not look towards them. Allah will not, you know, honor them. Another category of people, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, another hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives surplus of something to you, a water or wealth, and someone comes in to ask you for help, and you don't help that person. This is also, you know, falls in that category. رَجُلٌ بَايَعَ إِمَامًا. A person who did bait to an imam, of course not the imam of the masjid, but imam al-Muslimin, that I'm going to follow, obey you, and he doesn't do that, he also falls in that category. Another hadith, Rasulullah mentioned three people whom Allah will not talk on the day of Qiyamah. Allah will not look towards them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not honor them. Among them is al-shaykh al-zani. The person who is elder, he is, you know, elder person, but he commits adultery. He commits zina. He will be under that category. Malikun kadhaab. A ruler, but he lies. Why a ruler has to lie? He has the power, but he lies to his people. Alimun mustakbir. The person who is poor, but he is arrogant. Person, these three things doesn't make sense, right? A person who is elderly and he commits zina. And a person who is a ruler, but he is kadhab, doesn't make sense. A person who is poor, but he is arrogant, doesn't make sense. Another hadith, Rasulullah mentioned the same thing, thalathatun, three people who will be, Allah will not talk to them, will not look towards them, and Allah will not honor them, and they will have severe punishment. Al-aqqu liwalidayhi. The person who is disobedient to his parents. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save all of us. Al-aqqu liwalidayhi. The person who is disobedient to his parents, Allah will not look towards him. Allah will not talk to him. And Allah will not give him any honor on the day of Qiyamah. Al-mar'atu al-mutarahhidatu al-mutashabbihatu bi-rijal. A woman who acts like a man and who looks like a man. A woman who acts like a man, looks like a man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not look towards her on the day of Qiyamah. Allah will not speak to her on the day of Qiyamah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not honor her on the day of Qiyamah. Who is saying it? It's an authentic hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ad-diyuth. Diyuth is a person, in Arabic we say ghira. In Urdu also we say ghirat. Al-ghira min al-iman. Person who doesn't have ghira. Who doesn't have that protected, you can say, jealousy. He doesn't have ghira. Self-explanatory, inshaAllah. And another person, man ata imra'atan fi duburiha la yanzur ilayha yawm al-qiyamah. A person who does intercourse from the back passage, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not look towards him on the day of Qiyamah. And a person who drags his plot because of the arrogance, drags his plot. He is moving or she is, you know, going around, and her or his plots will be dragged because of the arrogance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not look towards that category of people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not speak to that category of people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not honor them. And as I said, imagine for a moment, we will be standing, and these are all sins. The first khutbah and the second khutbah that are related to the day of Qiyamah. Qiyamah means the day of standing. We will be standing, and there are these categories of people. Imagine for a moment. And as I said, just take this example. We have certain people who are shaded, right? Because of sadaqah, because of all those a'mal that we mentioned. Subhanallah, the sun is just very close by, and they are protected. They are special people. They are honored by Allah. And there are people who, because of these sins, did not repent to Allah. Of course, if we repent, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Who else can forgive our sins? It doesn't mean how bigger the sins are. It cannot be bigger than the mercy of Allah, from the rahmah of Allah. As long as me and you taking this breath, we have a chance. We have a chance. Inshallah, we continue this topic in the next khutbah as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among mu'mineen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us, all of us, from these sins that we mentioned. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, give us ability and tawfiq to do tawbatan nasuha before the time comes that we will not be able to do so. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. قال الله تبارك وتعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان. يا أرحم الراحمين، يا حي يا قيوم، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، نسألك توبة نصوحة، نسألك توبة نصوحة، نسألك توبة نصوحة، وتوبة قبل الموت، وراحة عند الموت، والعفو عند الحساب، والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا، وارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا، وارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى، واجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله، وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا بغير ربان، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا وتب علينا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله.
الله